So friends, I welcome back to my next lecture, and that is on the porcine infertility. I am Professor G.N. Purohit from the Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, College of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, Rajasthan, India. So friends, pig is a litter-bearing species, and 20 piglets are weaned every year with an average of 9.5 to 11. The pig usually delivers 2 liters every year. Sows have 12 to 14 teats, and 5% of the sows have 16 teats. The puberty occurs in pigs at 6 to 8 months, and the Yorkshire and the Landrace breed mature earlier. The puberty occurs at 200 days of age and 110 to 125 kg of weight. The mating is usually carried out of the second or third estrus. Now here you can see the reproductive tract of the sow. The reproductive tract of the sow is very long. The tubular genitalia are located abdominally, and the uterine horn is quite long. Here you can see very tortuous and long, and the body of the uterus again is very long, and the ovaries, they are mulberry shaped because of the many large follicles present on the ovaries. Here you can see the mulberry shaped ovaries and the cervical canal, which is having a spiral pathway with 5 interdigitating pods. The uterus is very long, 2 to 3 feet, lies in the abdomen, dorsal to the intestine. The vagina is 12 to 18 inches long, and the oviduct is 6 to 8 inches. The infundibulum is very large, almost surrounding the ovary. The sows are polyestrous throughout the year. The estrus cycle length varies from 18 to 24 days, average is 21 days. The estrus period is 40 to 60 hours or 1 to 4 days, slightly shorter in gills. The number of ovulations vary from 10 to 20, and the ovulation occurs 36 to 48 hours after onset of the standing estrus. May vary from 10 to 85 hours, and sows breed many times during a estrus cycle. One LH peak occurs in the pigs, and prolactin is luteotropic for establishment of pregnancy. At least 2 embryos are required in each horn. The pig conceptors secrete interferon delta but have no role in maternal recognition of pregnancy. The estrogens are luteotropic and secreted from day 11 to day 15. The gestation period for pigs is average is 115 days, may vary from 112 to 118 days. Now as far as breeding is concerned, one boar is sufficient for 20 to 30 females, and one adult boar may give 10 breedings per week, 5 females bred twice. Younger boars may give may serve 2 to 3 females in a week, and first mating in the sows, adult sows, can occur within 4 to 7 days of weaning. So weaning appears to be important for the lactating sow. Now it's important to mate animals of equal size and put sows in boar pens. The signs of estrus: the heat detection must be done twice daily and avoiding it at the feeding time. Boar exposure of daily boar exposure of 5 to 10 minutes would be sufficient for detecting estrus. Then nose to nose contact if boar his house near Gilts. And then the specific sign of estrogenic sow is the back pressure test or the lordosis. The secondary signs include red swollen vulva, altered vocalization, and mucus discharge. Now, subfertility in swine herds, we discuss something about that. The fertility rates in pigs are high, 95 to 100%. The farrowing rates are greater than 85%, stillborns less than 5%, mummies less than 0.5%, and abortion less than 0.8%. Now, a frequent cause of subfertility in swine herds is poor estrus detection. Mycotoxin contamination in the feed and bedding can result into subfertility. Mycotoxins caused by molds and fungi are present in grain and straw bedding. Zearalenone, a mycotoxin, can cause repeat bleeding and prolapse. Deoxynivanol can cause vomition, loss of appetite. Ergot alkaloids like rye, oats, wheat may cause agalactia and low piglet survival. Feed bins should be routinely emptied and washed and dried before they are refilled. The poor management at mating can be another cause of subfertility. Incorrect body condition score, poor or excess body condition score is not good. Breeding gills at too young age can result into subfertility, and the extremes of environmental temperatures can result into seasonal infertility in swine herds. Ovarian cysts may sometimes be a cause of infertility or subfertility in swine herds. Large cysts reduce fertility and small cysts reduce the litter size. The parameters in infertility evaluation include the herd size, age profile, weaning to estrus interval, conception rate, farrowing rate, lactation length, and total piglets born live or stillborn. So fertility problems in pigs are an estrus, conception failure, and the last one, pregnancy failure. An estrus. Puberty, pregnancy, and lactation are the commonest reasons for an estrus in sows. Sub-estrus is prevalent in summer, and one should also evaluate estrus detection before when one is confronted with the problem of an estrus. The ovarian activity can be detected by plasma progesterone. Detect estrus only once daily in the presence of a boar from the day of weaning. Then a very easy approach could be postmortem examination of ovaries from the culled sows. In large groups, inadequate space, inadequate diet, photostimulation, lack of boar stimulation, or poor flooring can lead to an estrus. PG-600 appears to be one of the most commonly used medicament for therapy of an estrus in both sows and gilts. A usual approach would be weaning of the sows followed by administration of PG-600. The conception failures can be total and partial. In partial, there is reduced piglets born. Normal conception rate is 90%. Returns higher than 10% are abnormal and usually unacceptable. The timing of service is most important. Most importance should be given on the day of standing estrus. It and 18 to 24 hours later. The service must be given on the day of standing estrus and 18 to 24 hours later. Sperm survive for 40 hours. Improper intromission, poor semen quality, rotate boars for optimum fertility. Then poor grouping of animals can also result in conception failures. Pregnancy failures. Failure, there could be two types. Failure to establish a pregnancy. This is difficult to establish and it is suggested to avoid stress at day 12 of conception. Embryos that die before day 35 are reabsorbed and after day 36 result in mummification. then failure of an established pregnancy, reduction in the numbers born live could be because of infectious disease. Fetal death after day 35 result in mummified fetus and common in viral infections like porcine parvovirus or Jaski's disease, swine fever, PRRS. Now we discuss about the infectious infertility. It can be classified into three groups. Group 1, infection with organism present in majority of pig population include organisms like E. coli, Listeria, Mycoplasma, Pasteurella, Salmonella, Klebsiella and Corynebacterium. These result into conception failure, abortion and stillbirths. Then the group 2, the contagious microorganisms including porcine enterovirus and porcine parvovirus that result into mummification and stillbirths. The group 3, relatively infrequent, but they result into severe reproductive loss and include leptospirosis, Jaski's disease and PRRS. So first we discuss porcine parvovirus. Porcine parvovirus is caused by a DNA virus and porcine enterovirus, BEV, are similar. They have a worldwide prevalence of 60%. They are a common cause of fetal deaths in litters produced by gills and immunologically compromised sows. The transmission is through fecal oronasal route as pigs shed the virus in feces. Transplacental transmission is also present. The virus is resistant to cold, heat and disinfectants and hence infected premises act as a reservoir. Porcine parvovirus is primarily a gilt disease. There is mummification of many fetuses in first parity gilts and there is a decrease in litter size and increase in the services per conception. The diagnosis can be done by serological tests and for control after one infection there is lifelong immunity. But the gilts must be vaccinated before their first breeding. Porcine reproductive respiratory syndrome is a disease of pigs caused by RNA virus transmitted by intranasal route and characterized by systemic illness in sows, abortion in sows and chronic respiratory problems in nursery age pigs. The clinical signs include anorexia, fever, abortion at 107 to 112 days, vaginal discharge, urinary infection, increased number of stillborn piglets. Newborn piglets show coughing, sneezing and a rough hair coat. Boars show listlessness and inappetence. The diagnosis is through clinical findings and virus isolation. For the control, remove older piglets every 10 to 14 days to distant places and vaccinate 3 to 18 week piglets and gilts 7 to 10 days before breeding. Natural herd immunity is attained in 4 months. But this is a very dangerous disease affecting a large number of sows and gilts. Then hog cholera or swine fever is an important cause of fetal mummification and abortion in pigs caused by a RNA virus transmitted by oronasal route and characterized by multiple hemorrhages in the lymph nodes, kidneys, spleen and infarction of the skin, spleen. The disease has been eradicated from the USA. The clinical signs include aborted pigs show subcutaneous edema, hydrops and ascites. The diagnosis can be done through demonstration of viral antigens in tonsils and fetal tissues. Then pseudorabies. The clinical signs include abortion, may follow fever and respiratory disease in susceptible gilts and sows, live-born pigs are weak and pneumonia can be seen in growing pigs. The vaccination will reduce the severity of the clinical disease. Then bacterial causes of infertility in pigs. Mixed bacterial infection. Then leptospira. Few clinical cases in previously exposed herd. Susceptible breeding females may abort or deliver weak or dead pigs. A vaccine is available for leptospira, so sows and gilts must be vaccinated 2 to 4 times each year. The feed and water should be protected from urine contamination. The rodent numbers should be controlled because they also contribute to the spread of the disease. Then Brucella suis causes abortion during any stage of gestation. In pigs, The preventive measures include prompt removal of the aborted tissues, routine testing for maintenance of brucella-free herds. Then urogenital infections and vulvar discharge syndrome. This is common in pigs, and the predisposing factors are high humidity, restricted movement, poor hygiene. The common complaints are vaginal discharge, dry deposit seen on the perineum or the floor, low grade fever and weight loss, increase in weaning to estrus interval, decrease in the number of liters per sow per year, endometritis, cystitis and pyelonephritis. Discharge rates of greater than 3% should be considered serious. The therapy include parenteral and oral antibiotics are inefficacious, and there are plenty of residue issues, so the use of antibiotics is of questionable value. Then the metritis, mastitis, achalasia syndrome. The etiology of this condition is poorly known. It is presumed to be because of E. coli. And for prevention, one should avoid sows to become overweight, clean the floors daily so as to maintain a good hygiene, increase the feed gradually after farrowing, and scrub sows before entry to farrowing crates. Maintain the farrowing temperature between 18 to 20 degrees centigrade. The diagnostic approaches for infertility in pig herds include transrectal palpation, but this can be done in a small number of breeds and must be done carefully. Transcutaneous ultrasonography above the stifle lateral to the mammary glands using a 3.5 MHz sector probe can give insights on the functioning of the uterus and the ovaries of pigs. A common approach is post-slaughter examination of the genitals from the sows or the gills. Then blood collection can be done using the saphenous vein of hind legs. So thank you very much. Kindly share the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel Govind Narayan Purohit if you like them. Thank you very much.